Brandon Castel, theozone.net, joins us now on the Subway Fresh Take Hotline. Brandon, you've read the prepared statements. You've heard from people. Tell me what this all means to you.
Well, yeah, I mean, I think going back to what you just said about it being an in-and-out process, I mean, in terms of what we're talking about here, it really was. I mean, 3.5-4 hours for one of these hearings is pretty short, pretty quick, pretty open and shut, really, based on some of the other ones, the USC hearings and things like that that lasted for 11 hours or 3 days. You know, they had to come back the next day and things like that. So it really was a kind of an open and shut case, and I think that was more a matter of Ohio State just working with the NCAA throughout the whole process to kind of stay on the same page, let them know what they're going through. I think some people in the public think that, you know, Ohio State is hiding everything from the NCAA, but apparently the NCAA has been convinced that they have been up front with everything, and they're right in line with that.
All right, well, Rothman's trying to have this little timetable thing going on, you know. Well, USC was 3 days, Boise was 11 hours, 13 hours, whatever. And so Ohio State's 4, okay? But then they send you a letter and say this thing isn't over, and then they tell you, well, it's going to be 8 to 12 months, which goes almost into
– Weeks.
Or weeks, I'm sorry, 8 to 12 weeks. So, yes, it was short, but that kind of says to me, yeah, it's short today, but there could be some more hours added on to this. Is that what you're feeling or no?
Yeah, I mean, according to the letter that they sent out, or the internal letter that they sent out back on July 13th, there was they put in that letter that they could hold a site where they weren't going to postpone today's hearing because they didn't have enough evidence, but that they could call a second hearing. So, I mean, it's completely possible that in the next couple weeks, I mean, I know Ohio State fans don't want to hear this, but that something could come back up and all of a sudden, hey, we've got another hearing on October, 25th, and we start all over again. Personally, I don't think that's going to happen unless they really uncover something in the further investigation. I don't think there will be a second hearing. 8 to 12 weeks seems like a long time, especially because originally Gene Smith said 6 to 8 weeks.
That's
now 8 to 12 seems like a long time to make a decision on something that they didn't feel like it didn't take them that long to have the entire hearing, and yet 8 to 12 weeks is a pretty long time.
Well, that's what I said. At one minute, when this whole thing started, I kept hearing they make decisions within, 6 to 8 weeks, 6 to 8 weeks. And then all of a sudden we hear today, they're impressed, I guess, with what was said. But then, but we're going to go 8 to 12 weeks now. That's what was confusing to me.
Well, that may actually have something to do with the fact that they are still doing the ongoing investigation. Usually when these things, come before the committee, they've already been the investigation has been completed, and they're kind of in that phase now. We know everything, and here's what we're going to do, and then we'll come up with the conclusion, and we'll come out with a report in 6 to 8 weeks. If they don't feel like they're done with their investigation, they may have added another 4 weeks on there to give them another month to finish up the investigation and figure out exactly where they stand on everything, make sure that nothing's changed by the time they release their report. That's what I'm thinking. That's why I'm guessing they added the extra 4 weeks in there.
All right, Gene Smith gave a comment today, and he seemed like he felt pretty confident about what transpired in that room in front of the NCAA. I mean, how do you feel about Gene and his job here? Do you think that should be safe, or how do you feel about that?
Well, I mean, I think that's one of the toughest things to really decide in this process is where does the athletic director fall in terms of what he's responsible for? Obviously, the NCAA seems to believe that he wasn't responsible, and that's the stance that Ohio State has taken and Jim Trussell's taken, that Gene Smith wasn't responsible in terms of knowing about what was going on, in terms of being, in the mix and knowing that players were playing ineligibly and, knowing that players were trading their memorabilia and stuff like that. So he didn't know about that. But does an athletic director get that benefit of the doubt, that plausible deniability? I didn't know about it, so I don't have to go down with the ship. I tend to think not. I tend to think that the athletic director does go down with the ship a lot of the times. If you look at some other schools, the athletic directors, maybe not right away, but in the near future, they don't usually last another 5 to 10 years. It's usually, maybe another year or so that they're around, and then, they're let go or they retire or they move on, because it doesn't seem like, if they get out of this without any more sanctions, he's going to look good, I guess, but I don't think he's looked great throughout the process.
Well, boy, yeah.
He's really said the right things all the way along.
Well, Boise just got rid of their athletic director.
Yep.
So
yeah, Boise got rid of their athletic director. At UNC, got rid of their athletic director. USC got rid of. I mean, it doesn't seem like that guy can stay around and just continue acting as if, you know, he wasn't overwatch of this.
Talking to Brandon Castel, the Ozone.net here on the Buckeye Show. I'll give you a wrap-up, Brandon. If nothing else happens, no proof, nothing happens in the next 8 to 12, and they come out with their penalties, what's the consensus right now on what you're hearing on what penalties they may face?
Well, I mean, if nothing else comes out, and it seems like what the further investigation is going to involve that sixth player, or did involve that sixth player, that player H, from the initial response that Ohio State sent in, if that's all they're investigating, then I don't think you're going to see a whole lot more than what we've already seen. Because if that's the case, then I really believe that the reason that the meeting today was so short is that Ohio State kind of already knew what to expect. They worked with the NCAA on you know what they think is going to be appropriate, and that's why they keep changing. You know, as you notice, Ohio State's the one that keeps coming out. It's a 2-game suspension. Now it's a 5-game suspension. You know, all these things, because I think it's a fluid situation where they're talking to the NCAA and they're trying to figure out, okay, what are we going to have to do to make this work? What are we going to have to do to appease them? I'm not saying that the NCAA can't come down hard just to prove to people that they can do that, but I tend to think if nothing else comes out, that really we've seen probably the worst of it. I mean, the worst I could see is maybe a few scholarships being reduced over the course of 2 years. I could not see a bowl ban, anything like that, unless something else came out in the investigation.
Brandon, thanks so much, man. Appreciate your time as always.
All right, guys. Thanks.